every single time we demo any affordable-ish speakers, people always say, have you tried the new iLouds? In fact, actually, it's been about 2 months now. We've done tons and tons of stuff. And especially when we start using speakers that have a system where they can read the frequency response in the room. And the reason why I say that is because everybody calls it a different thing. So it comes up a lot. So we did ask the good people at IK Multimedia to send us a pair of iLoud speakers, and they are the Precision 6s. So we are going to try them out. Very excited indeed. Uno. Dos. Okay, here's a 3.5 mini. My guess is this is probably going to connect the two speakers together. Maybe I'm wrong. Power cable. Oh, iLoud isolation pads. We've already got some isolation pads up here, but they come with the isolation pads. That's rather nifty. Look at that. So that's a big shout out for all of the people that always go, you have to isolate. On the SSL, we already have a mat and a separate thing which is isolated. Although we are using the isopucks as well. All right, let's get one out. Rather lovely. Look at there. Oh, there's some weight to it. These are rather nicely crafted. Okay, so there's a USB on the back here. So we have a base port on the back. You've got low frequency, 80, 50, full, low frequency flat, high frequency flat. Okay, well, we're going to learn about it. You've got level control there, center detented, XLR input, arc in. So the arc, that is a mic input. Aha! Was ist das? This is the mic. There you go. Speakers are up. Wonder how we connect it. And I wonder how we set up the arc system so that we can read the room and get the best frequency response for the speakers. Well, you know what? It's times like this, I wish I had somebody like Dave Kersner from IK Multimedia. Yes, Dave Kersner, the rather amazing prog rock keyboard player. I wonder if he is available.
He is.
That's
strangely
amazing.
Enough.
That was very well timed. Look at that. All right, so
how you doing?
We'll put them up.
Awesome. Oh, okay. So you're using your isolation pods and whatnot.
They already come up
with it.
I know. We did point that out.
Thank you very much. Really good. So this is the remote. This doesn't come with it. It's an option, but I highly recommend it because it does some really cool things. Basically, the iLoud Precisions, there's three different models. There's the Precision 5s, which have a 5-inch woofer.
Yep.
These are the 6s, which have a 6.5. And then there's the MTMs, which have 2.5s. And there are different price points, but all, you know, in that kind of...
How much are these talking price?
$8.99.
Okay, good.
Each, and then $9.99, and then $11.99. So the idea behind these is that they're a higher-end monitor, near-field monitor, than the very successful iLoud MTMs and the micro monitors, which are very popular because they're kind of small footprint, Bluetooth and things like that. And they're kind of like real world mix. These are essentially like for precision, precise mixing. You have a flat response. You have a linear flat response from like, I think it's 45 hertz to 30, which is rare. And what's cool, time-aligned.
I can't quite hear my 30 anymore.
And depending on the room, from 45, and then it'll actually go down below 40. Really rare to be time aligned and everything. And there's some benefits to that. One of them is you have clarity. You don't have the smearing of the frequencies and everything because it's hitting you at the same time.
Yep.
But the other is that it's a flat place to start if you wanted to model other speakers that have different phase. So like some, it has speaker modeling built in, and the voicings. And what's cool about it is it's more accurate than, let's say, the modeling where they just kind of do the frequencies, the response of it, whatever. It's that and the phase and everything. So it's very close. We've had various engineers and producers say, like, the NS10 model is indistinguishable from their NS10. And there was models of Adams and Danger and Marcella.
Right.
They said it sounded exactly like the... the A7s, and they know those. So, and there's ATC. So there's different ones. You know, some people are really into that. Other people want just a really good, flat, clear speaker. So what's cool about the remote, and you have, there's a software called X Monitor software. So you don't need the remote. You can just use the software.
Yeah.
But it's just handy to have the remote.
This is great.
You can switch between.
I never would have remembered all this without having them here. So this is making life a lot easier.
It's deep, but it's actually.
No, this is good.
Not. It's very easy to use, and it's the calibration's complex, but it's a 4-point around you with the mic instead of just one.
Should we set them up and accurate. Calibrate them?
Yeah, let's do it.
So I presume this is to connect the two together, yes?
Yes, and then also one of them is for the remote. So you connect the remote, and then the other one goes to each other. And the remote also helps with the calibration process. But what I was going to say is the software will allow these four buttons to do different things depending on what you want. Like, for instance, you could turn arc. Arc is room correction. So when you calibrate the speakers, you could turn it on and off. You want to hear it with or without. You can choose those different voicings, and there's all sorts of different speakers modeled. But if you're not into that, you can choose different calibrations. So you can actually calibrate from your sitting position or from the couch where the A&R man or the artist is sitting, or from standing, and you can just switch different calibrations from where you are. Because when you do the calibration, you do it from the listening position. And
right, that makes sense.
I heard you mention, so the ARC in, it comes with a measurement mic.
Great.
This is, you know, just for you don't use this for anything else, but for measuring, for the calibration process.
So how do we calibrate these little beauties?
You don't have to do this, but I would use tape. Yeah. And you basically put them, let's say, in front of the listener, starting with just to the left of the listener, right in front, and you do a square. So you do 1 point each like that, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Around where the listening position is.
Yeah, and from the listening position pointing toward the speakers. And this gets a more accurate calibration than the previous one, which was great already. So it's just going to be that much better.
So I'm going to be saying about,
And the reason I like to use the tape is because you're going to do this for each speaker, and I want to put it, I just want to put it in the same exact spot.
Okay.
I think there's some forgiveness. It doesn't have to be, but why not be accurate? So, all right. So we need an XLR cable from here to there. All right. So I'm going to put this tape right where this leg is. So when we're going to calibrate the first speaker with all 4 points, and after that's done, we'll do the second speaker, and I want to put this mic stand exactly where it was for the 4 points for this speaker. So if you hold this down for 3 seconds, the cal button, this blinks, and then when I hit it, everybody has to be quiet. It's going to do some sweeps. Okay, so now it went to 2, and that means we go to the second position, which would be here. I'm going to put tape there just to be sure when we do it next time. All right. And now, see, I don't have to, what's cool, you could do it from behind there and not have to use a remote, but the remote just lights it up and lets you know you're at 2. To me, that's the way to do it. Okay. Okay, and you notice it goes, it's fast and it goes slow and it'll show green. Actually, no, it'll show green at the end. If it shows red, it means it didn't calibrate right and you got to redo it. All right, so go back here, which would be the 3rd point. And the 4th one. Really easy. I mean, it's literally 5 minutes. And then you've like tuned your room. You know, people spend a fortune having someone come in and tune a room. You don't really have to do it with ARC. It does it for you. All right. There we go. Green light. That is calibrated. Now we have to do the same thing to the other speaker. The cool thing is the remote is connected to this through that mini cable, and that's connected to the other speaker. So we don't have to plug the remote into the other speaker. It's going through it. We just have to plug the measurement mic into the ARC XLR input in the back of the second speaker. And since we put the tape down, super easy, put it in this positions that we were just in. We just do it again. Green light, good to go.
Great, see what it sounds like.
Step one, you say you need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just talk. He smiles politely back at you. You stare politely right on through. Some sort of way.
My old drum room. Really, really nice, to be honest. It's like, usually, I won't say what manufacturers are, but certain ones, there's always a little bit of low-mid build-up that I'm trying to get rid of. This room's pretty flat. We had Gavin Haverstick flatten it out, so I've had a lot of fun listening in here.
So if you do the calibration, you know, obviously, everybody's room is different. Yep. So, and depending on how big it is and how far away you are from it, there's a lot of different things that could happen. Right. So you have some tweakability there. You were mentioning it before, with the high and the lows, you can bring it up or down a little bit if necessary.
Low,
but in a room like this,
pretty
you really
good.
Don't need to, yeah.
The kick felt fantastic. So this is a song I mixed in that room.
Okay.
On the SSL, on a pair of 1032 Genelecs.
Or increase it to a deafening roar.
Jack.
Now is the time to submit quietly. We control all you hear and feel. You are about to enter a great adventure and experience the awe and mystery from your ultimate fantasies to your deepest fears, from which you may never return.
Pretty darn good. That one, the kick low end and the bass was always like smudged together, where on the first one it wasn't. So I wanted to see if it was still smudged together or not. And it is a little smudged. But it is exactly how I remember it sounding. What I do like about this is there's an aggression in the high mid. Sometimes a lot of modern speakers really sound really boring to me. And I definitely want my speakers to be like, yeah! I wanted to be a little bit more, slightly more high mid aggressive and a bit more rock and roll and a bit more exciting.
Well, try some of the voices.
Yeah. So what? How do I do this?
So the first one is, I mean, you can change them with X Monitor software that comes with it for free. From the factory, it comes, first one is the calibration.
Yeah.
Second one is, I believe, it's an ATC-25.
Yeah.
A voicing. Third one would be an Atom. And the fourth is an NS-10. Yeah, I think the third one's the Adams. Yeah.
Definitely had a sense. Let your eyes can be your enemy. I said, my head is so close and heaven's out of reach. What's the third one?
The third one's the Adams. A7s. But there's other models. There's a whole bunch of them.
For me, it's like just go between the ATC modeling and the calibration as it is, because the ATC has a little extra.
Yeah. Well, wider dispersion. There's some other parameters and different things. So the main one would be more focused, and then some people like wide dispersion. So you can have different options.
Right.
But what I like about it, actually, because there is one thing in the physical world that you just can't do, even if you have a whole bunch of different monitors. They can't stay in the same space.
Sure. Yeah.
So they're wider or narrower in the stereo field. And this kind of, like, let's say for the person on a budget, you and I have multiple speakers. It's not a budget constraint, but some people have like physical space or budget constraints. But and it's a way to have like multiple monitors in the sense for the price of one. But for somebody who's just, let's say, can have as many monitors as they want, it lets you have different sounds in the same spot. And that's unique to this technology.
It's really good.
And those roads, they run through big fields,
Too much six.
Those roads, my heart, they come steal. They come steal.
Yeah, I really like these. These are really good. The calibrated sound is definitely my favorite. The ATC makes more sense. A little bit of extra low lows. Mm-hmm. Don't like the exaggeration of the 6-700 area. It makes the vocal sound a bit nosy. And I definitely pull that out of the vocal. Excessive notes, anyway. The 3 setting is just too boomy and in general. And then, of course, the 4, if it's an NS, obviously an NS10, has absolutely no low end whatsoever.
Right.
Which is actually, when I made this record, this is 2014, I probably had a pair of NS10s and a 1032s. So I was probably moving between the two. So strangely enough, it doesn't sound bad on the NS10s.
I flowed and put a question to my heart. A question oh so sharp.
Just doesn't have that body.
Well, he said, hey, wish man, tell me what's your wish. Close your eyes, all we got is this.
David, love them. Cool. They're really great. Rather fantastic. Like I said, everything I've been saying while we've been listening to the tracks is I enjoy that they're mid-range forward without being ear-blistering. So they're not painful to listen to. And I suppose what impressed me most is when I listen to stuff that I love that I've done, some of my better stuff, it translates in the way I remember them.
Right.
I would say they sort of have a characteristic of some sort of $8,000 Genelecs when properly done in this room. They have that sort of mid-range forward with just enough oomph underneath that I don't think I'd need a sub with them. Have you had people wanting to get subs or not?
There's different reasons why you would. The frequency response goes really low. I mean, depending on the room, it could go down to like 36. So you wouldn't need a sub. If you want to get more SPLs, Which, you know, okay. You could get that by putting it up to, let's say, 80 hertz and have the sub do the work for the low end. That's one benefit. It's been like
in this
some
size
hip-hop
of room,
artists.
Though, you know,
in a small room, I think, you know, you don't need it.
This is basically a converted kid's bedroom. Yeah, I couldn't see this as needing a sub. But then again, there's certain genres where you're probably going to have a sub no matter what your main speaker is.
Well, if you want to do immersive as well.
Right.
And these are great because they're less expensive but high-end. So for immersives, you have the fives, which are a little bit smaller, a little bit less money. And those would be great for, you know, 5.1, 7.1.
So how much are these a pair?
They're $1,000 each for the sixes.
Yeah.
$899 for the fives.
Okay.
$1,199 for the MTMs, which are a three-speaker system.
Right.
So it's $2,000 for the pair.
Yeah.
But, you know, for a high-end speaker, that's it's a good mid-price.
Yeah.
It's not $10,000.
Not $10,000. Yeah. My mains are always in the $8,000 to $10,000. Yeah. No, these have been absolutely fantastic. And of course, you can enter to win a pair. In fact, we're going to do a mega giveaway this month. It's these. Yeah. What else?
The Total Studio bundle. So you get all the software from IK Multimedia. And just the pair of those is $2,000.
Wow.
Plus we'll throw in a remote, which is another $100, and just like the full studio software. You'll have T-Rex, sample tank, Amplitube, all the sample libraries, some of the ones I do. And there's some mastering console and Moto drums, Moto bass, and you know.
The Moto drums are amazing. We've got to use them more often. I suppose I'm just a, you know, purist and end up, but yeah, those sound so good. So good. I think there's something about the restrictiveness of using samples in MIDI, which is great, that seems to be overcome by using those, where it's synthesized and just has this. I feel like I get a greater range of feel of sensitivity. Is that the right word? Dynamics. There you go. That's what I was looking for. I just feel like if I'm building up something on Moto drums, it just feels really, really supernatural.
Yeah, I mean, I do sampling. That's
I love samples as well.
And you get the recording, so you get the authentic sound of recording. With Moto drums being physically modeled, you have all that tweakability.
Yeah.
You do have some of those dynamics because it's doing it. It's approaching it a completely different way.
Yeah.
So the dynamics are also smooth. There's no sample switching. It's literally like the resolution of MIDI.
You can feel it. You honestly can feel that. If you're doing like a roll, you can feel it. It just feels as bad as natural as you can get. So I don't know why we're talking about that, just because they're really, really cool.
And you get it for free if you win.
If you win. So, as usual, enter down below to win. Thanks, Dave. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Warren.
Thanks. Great speakers. Really, really dig them. At $2,000 a pair, with this flexibility, and for my personal hearing, the way I want to hear music, these work absolutely fantastic. So, enter to win. So long, farewell, la vida, say, and au revoir, adios, goodbye.